It is the introduction of genes into existing cells to prevent or cure a wide range of diseases. It is a technique for correcting defective genes responsible for disease development. The first approved gene therapy experiment occurred on September 14, 1990 in the US when Ashanti De Silva was treated for ADA-SCID. Gene therapy also replaced a mutated gene that causes disease with a healthy copy of the gene. Inactivating or knocking out a mutated gene that is functioning improperly, introducing a new gene into the body to help fight disease. There are two types of gene therapy. First is the somatic cell gene therapy. Therapeutic genes transferred into the somatic cell. Example is the introduction of genes into bone marrow cells, blood cells, and skin cells. It will not be inherited later generations. At present, all researches directed to correct genetic defects in somatic cells. The second type of gene therapy is the germline gene therapy. Therapeutic genes transferred into the germ cells. Genes introduced into eggs and sperms. It is heritable and passed on later generations. For safety, ethical, and technical reasons, it is not being attempted at present. There are two approaches of gene therapy, the ex vivo gene therapy and the in vivo gene therapy. Ex vivo gene therapy is the transfer of genes of cultured cells and insertion. This is an example of ex vivo gene therapy. First, gene therapy to correct deficiency of enzyme adenosine deaminase. Performed on a 4-year-old girl, Ashanti De Silva, she was suffering from SCID, severe combined immunodeficiency caused due to the gene coding for ADA. Deoxyadenosine accumulates and destroys T lymphocytes, disrupts immunity, suffers from infectious disease and die at a young age. In vivo gene therapy. Direct delivery of therapeutic gene into target cell into patient's body. Carried out by viral or non-viral vector systems, it can be only possible option in patients where individual cells cannot be cultured in vitro in sufficient numbers. In vivo gene transfer is necessary when cultured cells cannot be reimplanted in patients effectively. Example of in vivo gene therapy. In patients with cystic fibrosis, a protein called cystic fibrosis transmembrane regulator or CFTR is absent due to gene defect. In the absence of CFTR, chloride ions concentrate within the cells and it draws water from surrounding. This leads to accumulation of sticky mucus in respiratory tract and lungs. Treated by in vivo replacement of defective gene by adenovirus vector. Vectors in gene therapy. To transfer the desired gene into a target cell, a carrier is required. Such vehicles of gene delivery are known as vectors. There are two main classes of vectors, the viral vectors and the non-viral vectors. Here are some examples of viral vectors. Number 1, retrovirus vector system. The recombinant retrovirus have the ability to integrate into the host genome in a stable fashion, can carry a DNA size of less than 3.4. Replication defective virus particles, and it also can target cell dividing. Adenovirus vector system. Adenovirus with a DNA genome, good vectors, and its target non-dividing human cell, for example, common cold adenovirus. Number 3, adeno-associated virus vector. It is a human virus that can integrate into chromosome 19. It is a single-stranded, non-pathogenic small DNA virus. AAV enters host cell, becomes double-stranded, and gets integrated into chromosome. Number 4, herpes simple virus vector. Viruses which have natural tendency to infect a particular type of cell, they infect and persist in nervous cells. Examples of non-viral vector system. Number 1, pure DNA construct. Direct introduction of pure DNA construct into target tissue. Efficiency of DNA uptake by cells and expression rather low. Consequently, large quantities of DNA have to be injected periodically. Number 2, lipoplexes. Lipid DNA complexes. DNA construct surrounded by artificial lipid layer. Most of it gets degraded by the lysosomes. Number 3, DNA molecular conjugates. Commonly used synthetic conjugate is poly-L-lysine, bound to specific target cell receptor. Therapeutic DNA is then made to combine with the conjugate to form a complex. It avoids lysosomal breakdown to DNA. And number 4, human artificial chromosome. It can carry a large DNA, for example, with one or more therapeutic genes with regulatory elements. Physical methods of gene delivery. First, gene gun. It employs a high-pressure delivery system to shoot tissues with gold or tungsten particles that are coated with DNA. Number 2, microinjection. Process of using a glass micropipette to insert microscopic substances into a single living cell. Normally performed under a specialized optical microscope setup called a micromanipulator. Chemical method of gene delivery. Using of detergent mixtures. Certain charged chemical compounds like calcium phosphates are mixed with functional DNA of desired function. The mixture is introduced near the vicinity of recipient cells. The chemical disturbs the cell membrane, widens the pore size, and allows cDNA to pass through the cell. Lipofection. It is a technique used to inject genetic materials into a cell by means of liposomes. Liposomes are artificial phospholipid vesicles used to deliver variety of molecules including DNA into the cells. Other types of gene therapy. Gene augmentation therapy. It is the most common form of gene therapy. Foreign gene replaces missing or defective gene. For example, replacement of defective P53 gene by a normal one in the liver cancer. Gene inhibition therapy. Done to block the overproduction of some proteins. There are two types of gene inhibition therapy. The first one is the antigene. It blocks transcription using antigene oligonucleotide. And the other one is antisense. It blocks translation using antisense oligonucleotides. There are also some advantages and disadvantages of gene therapy. These are the disadvantages. Long-lasting therapy is not achieved by gene therapy due to rapid dividing cells. Benefits of gene therapy is short-lived. Immune response to the transferred gene stimulates a potential risk to gene therapy. Viruses used as vectors for gene therapy may cause toxicity, immune responses, and inflammatory reactions in the host. Disorders caused by defects in multiple genes cannot be treated effectively using gene therapy. Advantages of gene therapy. Gene therapy has the potential to eliminate and prevent hereditary diseases such as cystic fibrosis, ADA, SCID, and many more. It is possible to cure heart disease, AIDS, and cancer. It gives someone born with genetic disease a chance to life, and it can be used to eradicate diseases from the future generations. Advantages of gene therapy. Gene therapy has the potential